గలాజయదేవ్ మాట్లాడుతున్నారు లైవ్ చూద్దాం
జి సెడ్ అండ్ ఐ కోట్ ది ఎన్డీఏ వుడ్ లీవ్ నో స్టోన్ అన్టర్న్డ్ టు డెవలప్ సీమాంధ్ర అండ్ మేక్ ఇట్స్ న్యూ క్యాపిటల్ అన్మ్యాచ్డ్ ఐ విల్ మేక్ సీమాంధ్ర ద గేట్వే ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పెరిటీ ఐ ఎమ్ నాట్ జస్ట్ మేకింగ్ ప్రామిసెస్ ఐ ఎమ్ అష్యూరింగ్ యూ రిగార్డింగ్ the capital formation sir the new capital for andhra pradesh sir the very next day in nellore again reported by the press in nellore modi praised the efforts of m venkai naidu quote if residual ap has got special status it is because of the efforts of venkaiya ji again sir these are all assurances given by the topmost leaders of both congress party and the bjp the leading opposition party and the ruling party and these are the assurances that the people of Andhra Pradesh have been listening to and have their hopes and have their aspirations linked to these assurances sir now suddenly if the people start talking about rules and go against the assurances it's a very sad state of affairs sir I would like to draw the attention of the house to the reply given by the minister of state for finance Shri Jayant Sinha on 25th April of this year to a zero hour submission made by my colleague Shri Avanti Srinivas on 21st December on conferring special category status on AP the reply really pained me sir as it has pained the entire state of AP in the last para the honorable minister said and I quote in the backdrop of recommendations of the 14th finance commission the union government has no proposal to modify the criteria for grant of special category status to states with all humiliation at my command I wish to ask one question sir which finance commission has recommended for granting special category status to Uttarakhand to Himachal Pradesh to any of the northeastern states sir were these recommended by any finance commission it was granted because of their finances were in a pathetic condition the union cabinet on the assurance of Sri Vajpayee ji in NDA 1 has conferred this status on them sir sir these expectations were created by both UPA 2 and NDA 2 before bifurcation after bifurcation and during the election campaign of 2014 to now say that this was not included in the AP reorganization act the people of Andhra Pradesh are feeling betrayed yet again sir by these statements sir the honorable minister also said in the letter that the promise made by the then PM Shri Manmohan Singh ji on the floor of the house was a remark during an intervention and there is no provision in the AP reorganization act sir it's not a mere remark sir when a prime minister of a country makes a statement on the floor of the house of parliament can we dismiss it as a mere remark sir is there no sanctity it was an assurance given by none other than then prime minister in parliament more particularly after it was insisted on by Shri Venkaiya Naidu garu on the floor of the house during the 2014 general election as I said earlier if residual AP has got special status Shri Venkaiya Naidu ji is responsible for it was a statement of Shri Modi ji at the election rally sir so the assurances given by none other than then prime minister should be considered nothing less than a provision in the AP reorganization act since it was given on the floor of the house sir if it is not an assurance why did it go to assurance committee in the Rajya Sabha and why did the assurance committee refer the issue to Niti Aayog and the government to fulfill that assurance so sir this assurance carries equal if not more importance than what was written in black and white sir in spite of all these justifications if the government wants to maneuver through various means to deny special category status the people of AP may be helpless now but we are not powerless sir We were powerless when the UPA bifurcated the state in the most unscientific and undemocratic manner. We showed our power by ensuring that the Congress party, who was responsible for the state of affairs, didn't even win a single seat out of 175 MLAs and 25 MPs in the 2014 election, sir. Now the feeling in AP among the public is that we are not getting justice, and if this is not corrected, the central government again will be seen as villains by the people of Andhra Pradesh, sir. And it's not just the people of Andhra Pradesh but the whole country is watching as we make our case will the government live up to the promises made to Andhra Pradesh Can we trust the government and the Prime Minister if they give us an assurance? Not only this government and this Prime Minister, sure. Any government, any Prime Minister, if they give an assurance on the floor of the House, what does it mean, sir? Can we take it as an assurance? Can we take it as a promise? Or do we insist on legal vetting and passing acts in Parliament are the only words that matter, and words made by people on the floor of the House don't matter, sir? I don't think so, sir. Sir, BJP is also for smaller states, sir. It carved out Uttarakhand, Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh in a very scientific and democratic manner during the NDA one. This was a good experience that gave even us in AP some hope about our future. But now, after seeing our experience, what will future candidates to become smaller states think, sir? They will remember unkept promises and financial difficulties that we're facing, but not anything positive, sir. And if we have to bring more states into the union and create more new states, this is not the experience that will help us to do that in future, sir. Sir, in the same way, Mr. Sinha, the minister, has mentioned in the second paragraph of his letter, and I quote, "Further, there is no specific provision in the Reorganization Act whereby the union government is mandated to provide revenue deficit grants to the successor states, as the grants required to meet the resource gap for the states are recommended by the respective finance commission in case the state is found to be revenue deficit after devolution of the state's share in divisible pool of central taxes over its award period." Sir, the Honourable Minister is very well aware that AP is the only major state which will remain as revenue deficit state even at the end of the 14th Finance Commission award period, after devolution of state's share in divisible pool of central taxes, sir. This substantiates that we are a revenue deficit state, and as assured, the union government has to help us out, sir. Sir, members of the government have been saying that we have given so many thousands of crores to Andhra Pradesh. Let me give a few details of the money given under different heads, sir. In 2014-15, the share of AP in central taxes was 16,839 crores, but we were given only 15,299 crores, sir. In 2015-16, the share was 22,638 crores, but till March 2016, we have received only 21,894 crores. And for 2016-17, we are expected to get 24,637 crores, but so far we have received only 1,760 crores, sir. Secondly, we have received grants as per the 13th and 14th Finance Commission recommendations under Article 275(1). You have given CST compensation of 1,800 crores out of a total amount of 3,500 crores due to us from 14-15 to 16-17. The government has given money for centrally assisted state plans of 23,000 crores till date, and Government of India has given revenue deficit grant of 2,803 crores in 14-15 and 500 crores in 15-16. But as per the calculation of the account in general, the deficit between June 2014 and March 2015 was 16,079 crores. But Government of India has given just 2,803 crores, sir. The remaining 14,276 crores has to be given to Andhra Pradesh, sir. And yes, we'd like to know, when is that going to happen? Sir, I'm sir, this is a very important subject about Andhra Pradesh. I'm sure even my colleagues, the rest of the MPs from other parties in Andhra want to hear this, sir, so please give me some time, sir. Sir, the point I'm trying to derive at is all the above assistance is given to other states as well, except for revenue grant deficit and the capital city grant, which are far less than what we require, sir. It is not that the Government of India has given this money only to AP. It's AP's rightful share, like any other state. So merely saying that thousands of crores are given to AP is a little misleading, sir. It was assured again on the floor of the House that backward districts grant will be given on the lines of Bundelkhand and KBK districts. But Government of India is just giving only 50 crores per district per year, which is not sufficient, sir. So the package given to KBK and Bundelkhand should be extended to backward districts of Andhra Pradesh on a per capita basis, sir. We're getting much less on a per capita basis than what was received in Bundelkhand. Sir, Section 94(1) of the AP Reorganization Act says that the central government shall take appropriate fiscal measures, including offer of tax incentives to the successor states to promote industrialization and economic growth. But here also, government of India has given just 15% additional accelerated depreciation, another 15% additional investment allowance. But this is not on the lines of 100% SenVAT income tax and service tax exemptions given to Uttarakhand and HP, which was promised to us, sir. So AP should also be given such incentives, which will help AP to attract investments, sir. Sir, even for Polavaram, the finance minister has so far given just 735 crores, sir. At this pace, it will take 57 years to complete this project. The government of India promised that it would complete Polavaram by 2018. So I asked the finance minister, how can you complete the project by 2018 with meager allocations? The government of AP has allocated 3,500 crores for Polavaram against government of India's 100 crores given in this budget this year, sir, even though it's a national project. The government of AP has already spent nearly 2,000 crores and has been requesting government of India to reimburse the same. It has also not been approved, sir. So these are some of the issues which I thought I should touch upon and request the Honorable Finance Minister to ponder over and do justice to AP, sir. Before concluding, sir, I would reiterate what I had said earlier, that AP is not a non-performing state, unlike other states which are deficit states, sir. We are a performing state, but by acts of this very parliament, we are put in this financial crisis. So it is for this very parliament to rectify the situation, sir. The people of Andhra Pradesh have been waiting patiently, but this patience is evaporating, to put it mildly. The real response is much more vociferous than I'm able to state in the House today. We are asking you to view this as an investment rather than as an expenditure. If we continue to be in financial crisis, it would be at the cost of the nation, sir. You will have to continue supporting us. But if you invest in us, we will quickly turn around and become a growth engine of the country, which we are very capable of becoming, and become a part of the growth trajectory of the country, sir. So I'm concluding, sir. Sir, we have heard many assurances from the Prime Minister and Finance Minister and others many times inside and outside this House, right from the time of bifurcation to the campaign during 2014 elections, and many times since the formation of the NDA2 government 2 years ago, sir. Now is the time for action, sir, not words or assurances. We need clarity and specific answers to the specific questions with respect to special category status, revenue deficit funding, Polavaram funding, capital city funding, industrial incentives in line with Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand, special development package for 7 backward districts in line with Bundelkhand, and a new railway zone, sir. We need to know in a comprehensive manner, not piecemeal, which will allow us to plan our finances, sir. We need to know for each of these what we will get, how much will we get, when will we get it, and how will we get it. Please answer these 4 questions in your reply, sir. What will we get? How much will we get? When will we get it, and how will we get it? This is what is eluding us all these years. Please answer this, sir. With vague assurances are creating more uncertainty and are no longer acceptable to us, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Please provide.